Hey guys, welcome back to the San Jose IMAX Dome Theater, the second largest dome theater in the country. Last year, we showed you how to change the 13,000 watt lamp inside the projector, and we also showed you how to build a 70 millimeter print of Star Wars The Force Awakens. But how do you play one of these big movies? What's all this stuff doing behind me? Today, I'm going to show you exactly how all that stuff works. When you arrive in the morning, the first thing you gotta do is clean the equipment. These are called rollers. The film will play along these during the show. There are 35 of them, and they must be wiped down with rubbing alcohol. Once that task is finished, you can open up the front end and clean the field lens. When it's dirty, you can see an imprint of the film on it. Wiping this down with Rain-X will keep moisture away. This is one of two film closets we have. Each one can hold up to 7 films at a time. Depending on the day's schedule, you may have to move films in the morning. 45-minute IMAX films can weigh up to 400 pounds, so they must be moved with this lift. We have a 3-deck projection system that only holds 2 films at once. Some theaters have 5-deck systems, which means you don't have to move films as often. Most films we play here are 45-minute documentaries. But we've also played films such as Harry Potter, Interstellar, The Dark Knight Rises, and of course, Star Wars The Force Awakens. These films must be clamped in so they don't fly off during a show. If that were to happen, the next step for you would to be start looking for another job. Once the hub in the center of the film is popped, you can then start diddling your way to the start frame. Yeah, this process is actually called diddling. You can be paid to diddle. Once you've diddled to the start frame, you can then select the show you're playing. Each film has its own runtime, which tells the projector when to stop playing a certain film. Once you hit initiate, the 13,000 watt xenon lamp inside the projector ignites. The front end of the projector must also be wiped down with rubbing alcohol. If a dirty film has just played, pink emulsion will have rubbed off it during a show. Some films are worse than others. The more times a film is played, the dirtier it becomes. When all emulsion is wiped away, the front end is blown out with pressurized air. This is the sound system. Because the picture on the 70mm frame takes up so much space, there is no room for audio. All audio tracks are on DVDs that must be synced to the film. A careless projectionist can end up playing the wrong audio for the wrong film. Audio on the DVD must match the timecode on the projector. This is called the brain. The film starts its long journey from platter to projector and back from here. The brain controls the speed of the film. Once you have threaded the film through the brain, you close this gate, which keeps tension on the film. You don't want your film to go slack. The film follows a specific path through the rollers. The more twists and turns, the more tension is created. Plus, they also help to align it properly. Once you have placed a film through the front end, you must align a frame line with this white line right here. This keeps you in sync. You must do this on either side of the projector. Both frame lines are now aligned properly. Now you can finish threading. This particular film will end on the bottom platter. Once a film is threaded, it cannot be rewound as the projector only plays in one direction. This foil strip near the start frame is useful. Once you've threaded, you want to jog the start frame all the way to the lens. As the film is jogging, the projector looks for this foil strip. Once the strip reaches the sensor, the projector stops jogging. If aligned properly, you would see the start frame through the lens as an upside-down A in the word start. Then you can wrap the bladder around the lens, check to make sure your numbers match, and then send the projector up into the theater. minute before showtime, the projectionist will talk with a console operator up in the theater. He performs the pre-show speech and maintains audio and video quality during the show. And if you have your phone out, he will also come down and tell you to put it away.
Now sit back, relax, and enjoy the mysteries of the unseen world.
Once the speech is finished, the projectionist will start the show. Show is over, the projectionist brings the projector down. A good projectionist will already have the next film prepped and ready to be threaded. On a typical day, you would have about 15 minutes of turnaround time. It's much better to take your time and do this process correctly than to try to speed up and potentially miss a step. Everything here is very expensive and hard to replace. Oh, and that right there? It says IMAX. To remove the film, simply release the tension and pull it out of the projector. On any given day, you'll do this 7 or 8 times. So that's it, guys. That's how 70mm IMAX film is played. You don't just put in a Blu-ray. There's a lot of other steps. So I hope you've gained a new appreciation for what IMAX projectionists do and what IMAX represents. And remember, IMAX is not an acronym. It stands for Image Maximum. So the next time you're debating whether to see a movie in digital or 70mm film, choose IMAX. It's epic! I'm John Ruddock. Enjoy your show.